Mike Kellum with you once again here on CWS Asheboro, the Carolina Wrestling Showcase. And once again, I get to commentate another great matchup involving Lou Marconi. Of course, Lou Marconi, the NWA National Champion, won that belt back in March 2014. And his opponent in this one is the CWS Legacy Champion, which is basically the heavyweight champion of this organization, Scotty Matthews. Both of these guys with quite a reputation. Phil Marconi, a veteran of this sport. Been in it a long time, since the mid-90s. However, still relatively young in wrestling terms. Had to retire for a few years between 2000 and 2005 due to an injury. Came back stronger than ever. And now, of course, the reigning and defending NWA National Heavyweight Champion. Think of time he has held that title. These two had quite a few going. He won that NWA National title, like I said, back in March. Then he came here to CWS Asheboro and had a belt versus belt match against Scotty Matthews. Last time we were here, no definitive winner there, so we've got round number two. However, this one, just a grudge match to see who the better man really is. Scotty Matthews with a nice tank there. Of course, Ed Malice out here, he has been sticking his nose in both of these guys' business since day one. Always wants the best wrestlers under his management here in the CWS. He says, by the end of this night, Lou Marconi, you will want me to be your manager. Not sure what he has planned. I guess we'll just have to wait and see. Right now, though, we have a great matchup go behind here by Lou Marconi. Scotty Matthews trying to basically power out, and he does. Now go behind by Scotty Matthews. Nice veteran move by the national champion to get to the ropes. These two guys very evenly matched. Very similar in size. Either man could come out on top in this one. Both men just kind of feeling each other out now, really. You see Scotty Matthews has a crowd behind him, and Lou Marconi just the opposite. You can see Lou Marconi's like, okay, whatever, I don't care about you, man. Another go behind. They're both men kind of testing each other out here early. They know what each one is capable of, and neither one wants to make a mistake. Oh, another drop toe hold, and nicely done by Scotty Matthews, just kind of mocking Lou Marconi here. Lou going outside the ring, taking a little break. Very smart by the national champion. Now Lou Marconi is hitting the back. What is he doing here? Referee making the count. Lou better get back out of here, or he's going to be counted out. He just went back through the curtain.
You trust me?
I can tell you right now, that is not going to happen with a headlock. Lou Marconi, I'll tell you what, though, he'll turn that into a little chug if he can get away with it. Maybe a little too hard to hold down on the mat, so look his way back up, and now look at this. Scotty Matthews fighting out of it, but once again, Lou Marconi one step ahead, driving that knee into the midsection. What Scotty Matthews thinks about Ed Malice holding the Legacy Championship as well. He's got both belts out there. What in the world is going on here? CWS can't be happy about that, holding that Legacy title outside the ring. With Ed Malice also the manager of Paco Loco and Bill LaVue, newcomer. Doesn't always come out with Bill LaVue, but or LeBeau, however you want to pronounce it, but he's definitely advisor to that young man. He just started off in his business. Ed Malice, he said, wants to take total control of CWS Ashboro. Now look at this, up a shot to the midsection. Another one by Scotty Matthews, and another blow by Lou Marconi, the national champion. Oh, look at that. Really working over those ribs. You gotta wonder how much of that Scotty Matthews can continue to take.
That's it!
Oh, that's it. Let's see if he gets him. No. Two count only by Lou Marconi. Marconi once again going back to that headlock. Wearing down the Legacy Champion. Hey, Matthew's trying to get that crowd behind him. I tell you what, there's been some great Legacy Champions as of late. Scotty Matthews definitely continuing that great lineage right here in Ashboro. Crowd starting to get behind Scotty Matthews. A lot of that probably has to do with Ed Malice being out here in Lou Marconi's corner. Nobody likes Ed Malice. Look at that. He pulled the trunks and takes him right back down. And as usual, Lou Marconi just wearing him down here. Lou Marconi, nothing fancy, never has been. But what he is very effective. Great wrestler, great athlete. Old school all the way. But the court fits the mantra of Ed Malice perfectly. Ed Malice looking like now he is cheering on Lou Marconi, which is no big surprise. I know I was glancing on when he first come out, he come out looking, here's another cover. When he first come out, he acted like he was just out here to protect the belts, like they need protecting. Now it's pretty obvious he is cheering on Lou Marconi. Everyone should have known he was going to do to begin with, since he actually said he wanted to be Lou Marconi's manager. Marconi driving that shoulder into the midsection and just continuing to pound away on Scotty Matthews. Those ribs have got to be just taken at this point. Look at that, the roll up. Will they get him? Oh, almost. Boy, Lou Marconi's like, he almost got me there, but he didn't. Now Lou Marconi stalking his prey. He goes over into the corner and just lays a big right hand into the Legacy Champion. Scotty Matthews, though, fighting back. Well, we have a battle on our hands here tonight. Big knee right to the midsection, and once again, Lou Marconi continuing to work on those ribs. No, what's he got planned for him here? I don't know. Marconi got a few words to say to the fans. This may be a mistake. Can't waste a lot of time with somebody like Scotty Matthews, and he misses. Scotty Matthews moves out of the way. Lou Marconi was going to go to those ribs again with that elbow. And now, we've just got a pure six brawl. Scotty Matthews gets the best of that exchange. Waits for him to get up. Oh, big double chop, and now what he's got planned for him here. Clothesline. Covers him, hooks the leg, and no. Not quite enough. You tell Scotty Matthews, indeed. Still hurt from earlier, and there, once again, Lou Marconi driving his head into that midsection, and now Lou Marconi looks a little frustrated. He is just choking him here. Ed Malice coming up to the ring apron. I'm not sure what in the world he is doing, but he has got that belt, and he just handed it to Lou Marconi. And the referee is there. No, you can't do that. Misses, drops it down, and now going for a back suplex. Can't quite get him, and something happened there. I don't know if he got hit or what. It's like he grabbed his head, and that's a three count. Ed Malice must have got involved. He had to. There's no way anything was done in that moveset that would pin Scotty Matthews like that. He had to hit him in one of them belts. Hard to tell from our vantage point. Couldn't really see, but nonetheless, Lou Marconi is your victor tonight. But who will win on Thanksgiving night? Right back here at CWS Asheboro at the French Community Center. It's anybody's guess because both of these men very evenly matched, but it looks like Ed Malice may be in Lou Marconi's corner. Can't really tell. You see Lou kind of waving him off. But if he is, that will definitely be a deciding factor. I'm Mike Kellum, thanking every one of you for joining us here today. So long, everybody.